kids, guess what's behind my back?
What's behind your back?
Oh, look at this thing. It's so cute. Oh, can you hear that? Oh, so satisfying.
What is he doing?
I think he's hearing.
That's it.
Oh, he's hearing. Well, what am I doing?
Ooh, sparkles. I love sparkles.
So cool. I love the way you're making it.
You're touching?
Yes.
Yeah, she's feeling it.
All right, are you ready?
So nice.
You are smelling.
Rose. Ooh. That's right, kids. Today's episode is all about your
senses.
Crunchy, munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy!
Oh yeah!
Attention shoppers, welcome to Greenland Mall. There is Crunchy Munchy available at every till. Help yourself.
Did you hear that, Uncle Matt? Crunchy Munchy's available!
Huh, just because it's available doesn't mean it's for you, kid.
But I want some!
Wait a sec, Aisha. Let me just choose from this fine assortment of unique, finely crafted hats. You know, Uncle Matt needs a new one.
Crunchy, huh. Munchy, they all look the same to me, crunchy, Uncle Matt. Munchy, crunchy, choose munchy, one. Crunchy, I want my Crunchy Munchy!
Hey, Mom told you that you can't have any sugary snacks or else you'll be bouncing off the walls even more. Right before your photo shoot. Photo shoot.
My dress is so pretty and I know how to eat, so I won't dirty my dress. And you can tell my mom that, okay? Uncle Matt.
Aisha, you
crunchy
know
what the crunchy munchy.
And right now, you want the wrong thing. No crunchy munchies for you.
It smells so good.
Ignore it. We have a mission. You gotta take your photo.
Choose your hat. I want my candy.
No, I can't even concentrate.
I want
on
the
my
candy!
Hats. They're so detailed, I need to focus on them, but I'm looking at you.
They're brown and straw.
Yeah.
Choose one.
Keep telling me. Don't focus on the candy. What else about these hats, Aisha?
I don't know if they're gonna keep you warm for the winter here.
Go on. Go to Aisha. Look at me. Look at me,
candy.
Aisha. Aisha, no candy, Aisha. Okay, we're almost to the photographer's stall.
Oh my goodness, have you seen the popcorn?
I see it.
I want some. Now.
Aisha.
Some popcorn now.
Number one, you say
it
please.
Smells so good. Oh my, I want some.
I know it smells good, Aisha, but you can't
the popcorn smells so good and buttery. Oh, I want Uncle Matt.
Oh, yeah.
May I please have some popcorn? Please? Smells so good.
Doesn't matter if you say please. If you have a rotten attitude, you're not getting nothing.
A rotten attitude?
Yeah, you know.
Uncle Matt, have you smelled this popcorn?
Mommy
it smells
said,
so
no
good.
No food, no sugar.
My dress won't get
your
dirty.
Christmas phone.
My dress will not get dirty. I want some popcorn.
Aisha?
Give me the popcorn!
Aisha, focus. Look at me.
Look at me, Aisha. It smells.
Look at me, Aisha.
So good.
Wait.
Can I have some?
We will handle
please?
It after.
Please.
You may be.
Please.
Sir,
please?
Perhaps. Might possibly.
Please! I want some popcorn!
Be able to have some popcorn.
Give it to me now!
After your photo shoot.
I can't take it. I want some popcorn!
Oh, we're next. Let's go.
You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you, I worship you. Touching every heart, I worship you.
Aisha.
So good.
So, let me talk to you.
I can't wait to have my popcorn, Uncle Matt. It's so yummy. I'm ready.
I gotta talk to you first, Aisha.
I can have some now?
Nope, wait a bit.
Okay.
Now, Aisha.
5 seconds?
Let me finish. Aisha.
Yes?
At the mall, you were ravenous. Going after Munchy Crunchies and popcorn like there was no tomorrow.
Uncle Matt, I don't know what ravenous means.
Ravenous. You were wild. You just were
wild?
Craving it. Yeah, you just went for it.
But Uncle Matt, did you not hear the advertisement in the mall? Crunchy Munchy. And everywhere we went, free, take it at the cashier. I wanted some. Then the popcorn, oh my goodness, smelled so good.
So
buttery and salty. I just had to have some.
Yeah. I heard that too. I smelled that too.
So good.
Yeah. So what happened, Aisha, was that you were getting fed information through your ears with the advertisements all day. Munchy, crunchy, crunchy, munchy.
Munchy, crunchy, I want some popcorn.
And the smell of the popcorn drove your senses wild.
So good.
But, you know, the Bible says all those who are children of God are led by the Spirit of God.
I love Jesus.
And when, you know, you were running after Munchy Crunchies and popcorn, you were led by your senses.
My senses?
Yeah, not the Spirit of God. You were led by your nose towards the popcorn.
No, Uncle Matt, yeah.
And you were led by your...
It smelled so good. From my nose, I smelled it.
And you were led by your ears with the advertisements.
That's true.
And your eyes too.
I have good hearing.
But if we love Jesus, we have to know that we're led by the Spirit of God.
The Spirit of God?
Yeah.
Holy Spirit?
That's right, Aisha. So when we are overloaded in our senses, when we smell things and see things and want things, maybe...
Like the popcorn?
That's right. Maybe we gotta just take some time and wonder, is this what God wants? Is He leading me towards that?
You mean God doesn't want me to have this popcorn?
It's not that simple. It was more about when you were going to have the popcorn. Because Aisha,
yes,
your mommy wanted you to take a photo in that dress.
In my pretty dress?
And mommy said specifically to me, Uncle Matt, that you shouldn't be eating sugary things or anything at all. So to honor mommy, which is what God wants you to do, you had to wait until your photo before eating popcorn or Crunchy Munchies.
Uncle Matt,
are
you gonna tell my mommy about my behavior?
Well, Aisha, just enjoy your popcorn for now.
I love your hat, Uncle Matt.
Thank you, it's brand new. Just bought it.
I give myself away.
Oh.
To you, popcorn.
Oh my goodness.
So yummy.
Thank
you, Uncle Matt.
You're welcome.
Welcome back, boys and girls, to Super Science with Super Sarah. Today, I am showing you something awesome. Do you know what this is? It is. Oh, I'm feeling it. It's very squidgy. I see lots of holes. Boys and girls, do you know what this is? This is a sponge. And today I want to show you something really cool with a sponge, because sponges are very special. When you put them in water, all of the water gets sucked up into the sponge. The sponge sucks up all of the water. And I want to show you today how that works. If you want to do this at home, you don't need that much. You just need a container of water, some food coloring, and a sponge. And I want to show you something really cool. Are you ready? So what I did was I filled up my big container with blue food coloring, and I'm going to take a blue sponge, and I'm going to place my sponge inside the blue food coloring water to see what will happen. Here we go. As the sponge goes in the water, I can see the water going up into the sponge. That means the sponge is absorbing, it's taking in all of the water and sucking it inside itself. And so now I'm gonna allow the sponge to get fully wet by putting it in the water. So boys and girls, now the sponge is full of water. The sponge has absorbed the water. And what's really cool is I'm now going to lean the sponge over the side of the other container that doesn't have any water in it. So I'm going to bend the sponge over the two containers. So half of the sponge is in the blue water and the other half of the sponge is in the other side in the empty container. So this is so cool because half the sponge is on the blue side and the other half is in the empty container. And so the water is traveling through the sponge and it's going to the other side and beginning to fill up the other side. It is so cool. And this reminds me a lot of the senses that we've been learning about today, because just like the sponge that absorbs all of the water that it's in, our senses absorb a lot of things into our heart, into our soul. Everything we hear at school, boys and girls, we hear good things, sometimes we hear things that are not so good. Everything we see at school, sometimes we see people being kind, and sometimes we see people that are not being very kind. What happens sometimes is those things come out of us. You know, boys and girls, sometimes there's that boy in the playground that says something mean and you feel really sad, maybe a little bit angry, and it goes inside your heart and you're feeling hurt, and then you go and say something mean to someone else. That's a little bit like what I'm talking about. You know, I hear someone saying something mean and I feel hurt. My senses go into my soul and my soul begins to do the same thing or say the same thing. So it's a bit like the sponge. You see, the water is coming out on the other side. But boys and girls, we don't want to be like that, because God says that our spirit can rule. Our spirit can take control. And so when we hear things and see things and they go inside of our soul, what can we do to allow our spirit to lead? Well, that's a really good question. And I'm going to show you with another small experiment of what we can do to help our spirit to lead over our soul. So boys and girls, I want to show you one more thing, okay, before you go. So this was the blue sponge, and I'm going to put it in this water to clean it and take away all of the blue that it absorbed before. Because even though things come in through our senses, and sometimes they're not good things, the Lord tells us that we need to allow our spirit to lead over our soul. So what do we do when our senses are overloaded and our soul is full of things that are not good? Well, we need to go to Jesus and we need to ask Him to help us, because He can wash us, He can purify us, He can make us clean, and He can make things right. Just like this sponge as it's going into the clear waters. When we go to Jesus and we ask Him, Jesus, can you help? Can you help me to wash my heart? Can you help me to clean my heart? Jesus can do that. And that's how we allow the Spirit to lead us and not our soul. So boys and girls, have fun with the water and the sponges. I don't know about you, but I love the feeling of water and feeling it between my fingers. Enjoy the senses that God has given you and enjoy the water and the sponges. Until next time, ask Jesus to help you to be led by your spirit. Bye for now.
Little tongue, what you say, for the Father up above.
Kids, no matter what,
hot or cold,
don't let your soul lead.
Pastor Sarah, let's pray for USA.
That's a great idea.
All right, here we go. Father.
Crunchy, munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy, munchy, munchy, crunchy, crunchy, munchy, munchy, crunchy, crunchy.
I'll be right back.
Hallelujah. I'm looking at the man in the mirror. I'm looking just a hee-hee, cause it's his thriller, a thriller night. No one prays when Dr. Distracto enters the room.
Welcome, boys and girls. I'm so glad that you joined us for Bible story time. You know, the Bible is the best book in the whole wide world, and I love sharing stories right from this Bible with you and your family. Now, all over the world, we're about to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, and that holiday is Christmas. Do you like Christmas? So do I. It's a wonderful time. But where did the tradition of gifts come from? Well, you know that Jesus is the ultimate gift to the whole world. But when Jesus was born, there were three wise guys who brought gifts to celebrate the new king. So let's look at that story together. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came three wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him." Now when Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered the chief priests and scribes of the people together, that's all the smart people, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. Isn't that interesting? And the chief priests and the scribes said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, and thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel." Whoa. Then Herod, when he had called the wise men, asked them diligently, "What time did the star appear?" And then he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go, search for the young child, and when you've found him, bring me word that I may come and worship him also." But you know he was just tricking. He didn't want Jesus to be king because he wanted to be king. Well, when they heard the king, the wise men left Jerusalem. And look, the star which they saw in the east
went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. And when those wise men saw the star, they rejoiced with great, great joy. Why do you think? Well, I'll tell you. Prophet Shaiju said that it was the Spirit of God that caused these wise men to see the star. But then when they saw Jerusalem and they saw that shiny palace, I think maybe they heard the royal music and thought a king might be there. Maybe they saw the shiny palace and thought a king might be there. So they were using their senses to figure things out, their soul, instead of being led by the Spirit of God. But when they left that palace, the Lord allowed them to see again. And led by the Spirit, they went all the way to where Jesus was. And when they came into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshiped him. And they opened up their treasures and gave King Jesus presents. Isn't that an amazing story? So children, I want you to keep seeking and keep letting the Lord lead your spirit so that you can know Jesus deeper and deeper all the time. And bring your life to him as a beautiful gift. Maybe you can't give Jesus gold or frankincense or myrrh, but you can give him you. And that's a beautiful gift indeed.
Hey kids, I just want to say, praise the Lord!
Isn't that amazing that Jesus renews us every single day? I love it.
I like munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy,
munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy, munchy, crunchy.
Okay, I love the song, but I also love the lesson that we learned that if the soul is really craving or really wanting something, our spirit is in control. And we can just say, no, that has to wait, and we'll move forward with what God has planned for us.
Well, let's move forward with prayer. Boys and girls, wherever you are, reach up for Jesus with us. Lord Jesus, we thank you that through you, we are no longer slaves to sin.
Amen.
That through you, we can be led by the Spirit of God. Lord, we ask you to renew our soul every day and teach us how, that we would be children of God, led by the Spirit of God, and that you would get all the glory. And we ask this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Well, have a great afternoon or evening or morning. And we'll see you next time.
We'll see you soon.
Once more.